I can't. What if I look like this all the time?
It's so sad.
Monday. OMG, you know how much I love Mondays. Love Mondays. I hope y'all had a fantastic weekend. I know I did. I got a lot done. The twins absolutely love their new little toy that we bought over the weekend. I guess we bought it on Friday. But anyways, had lots of fun with that. Had some minor issues with it, but you'll see all that in the video today. But anyways, just had a fabulous weekend, but had some devastating news over the weekend to do with one of my projects. And I thought about it and I thought, you know what? I can either let this get me down and I can just scrap the whole idea, or I can go back to the drawing table and figure out what do I need to do differently to make this project a success. And I'm telling you what, you know, a lot of you guys always think that if you try something and it doesn't work, it's a sign from God that you're just not meant to do it. Or I knew I shouldn't have even tried to do it because it wasn't gonna work. Or you always go back to thinking something negative. And I'm here to tell you, number one, I'm totally the opposite, but I'm here to tell you also that for anybody out there that's ever succeeded at doing something, they failed at it many times before they became successful at it. Let that sink in for a minute. They failed out at it numerous times before it ever became successful. But every time they failed at it, did they just throw in the towel and say, yeah, I knew it wasn't gonna work. Oh, I knew I shouldn't even have tried. Oh, it was a stupid idea. I don't know what I was thinking. No, they go back and go, okay, what part of this is not working? How can I make this work? What can I do to change things to make this work? And so it made me go back to the drawing table, come up with some ideas, brainstormed a little more, bounced some ideas off of some people that I consider pretty close in my circle, business type people, and I've come up with a new strategy, and I'm going to try it this week and see if that strategy on this project is going to help me get it going. So I guess my motivation here, the message today, is just because a door closes on you doesn't mean it's over. It just means that there's another opportunity awaiting. You just have to open some other doors and see if that's the door that's going to lead you to success. I can't tell you how many times I've had doors slammed in my face. I can't tell you how many times I've had people say no. I can't tell you how many times I've run up against roadblocks that in some ways, if I would have looked at it in a negative way, I would have thought, you're right. It was a stupid idea. Why was I even thinking this? But I never thought that. I thought, no, this is a damn good idea. It's going to work. I just have to figure out how to make it work. And I'm telling you, every successful entrepreneur out there has had these same issues I'm talking about. Exact same issues. And I'm telling you, they've probably attempted many, 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 many times that you have never seen because you only see the finished project. When you see the finished project, you're like, oh, well, that was easy. I'm telling you now, nothing is ever easy. Anything worthwhile is hard. It takes a lot of elbow grease, a lot of time, a lot of dedication, sometimes a lot of selfishness to try to get it right. But a lot of you think just because you see the finished project, you're like, oh, well, why can't I have things happen to me like that person had happened to them? You don't know the blood, sweat, and tears that went into that person's getting that project off the ground. So anyways, I hope you enjoy today's message. I hope you enjoy today's video. We had a ton of fun over the weekend, and I just want to share it with you right here.
All right, and here we have the guys working on trying to figure out how they're gonna do some platforms up there to be able to stand on, to be able to get onto the seats. Yeah. Diego's all the way over there. Me and Diego. What a beautiful day, you guys. You got the chickens over there. Aw, they're just loving that sun tree. Getting some shade. Getting to roam around. Yes. So they're over here. This is the first platform they're making. Boys cannot wait. They're so excited, as I already have one on a dirt bike. All right. Yeah, we'll have to get Sergio to.
This one's way too tall.
I think he's gonna build you a step. I think so.
No.
Yeah.
I don't need a step, it's just too tall.
No, but he's gonna build a step that you stand on so you can get onto it.
It's too tall. I'm actually gonna try to ride it. It's always too tall. Okay.
Oh, this woman, I tell you guys. Oh, look at that sun. He's so pretty. So pretty. What was that?
That's a lot of tree limbs that they were supposed to take today.
Oh, the lawn guys?
Yeah, and I'm still not done trimming. Looks how clean it looks now.
I know. I was actually just talking to the boys about that.
Now, don't have weeds and snakes and all that crap up there. Look how clean. Ooh. It's got me cleaned up, trimming some more branches up.
Got the boys over there on the zip line. Mom, you want to go on the zip line? No.
Did it.
Okay.
I'm busy.
Okay. Look at her get up, you guys. Yeah.
With my procedure done on my face.
You don't look bad. Really? Looks like you got just a little bit of sun.
Yeah.
Nothing crazy.
Look at that tree move.
I know. That's what scares the boys.
Where am I going?
Look at it. Just
pine trees are meant to move in the wind.
Oh, yeah. But hopefully that was the right tree to pick. Girls trip cheaper than therapy. Oh my God, isn't that true? Mm-hmm. We need one, mother.
I just offered you one today.
All right, we just got to Custom Cart Pros. We're gonna go in and see what we can find for some go-karts. Let's go. Oh, look at this cute little guy. It's cute.
Ride at home.
Oh my goodness, look at all these golf carts. So I told mom she needs to get rid of her golf cart that she has now and needs to buy this pink one. Like, yes. I could see mom. Definitely. Look at the little dune buggy over here. Ooh, boys are so excited. Seriously, if y'all are in need of a golf cart or dune buggy or some really cool motorcycles, Custom Cart Pros is the place to go. It's family owned business. But look it. Oh my gosh, look at the little tiny motorcycles. Yeah. See what kind of fun we can get into today. Ooh, look at that green one, that's pretty cool. All right. Let's go see what mom's gonna do here. Look it. She's even blending in with the golf cart. It's meant to be. All right, guys. Look at mom. And it's even her favorite color. Look at you.
What do you think?
I think it's cute.
So many toys.
Need to get you a helmet.
I think that's why there's a roll cage.
Yeah.
Well,
I don't know.
And seat belts.
You guys, mom just got her toy today. It's gonna be delivered today. And then look at, see, I told y'all, look at, you could be like Barbie. Yes.
It's a little bougie, don't you think? It's got a touchscreen.
Does it really?
Oh yeah.
Oh my
yeah.
God, no.
This is like way fancier than ours. Like, it's got touchscreen. Like, I would be afraid to drive this at the ranch because this would get, look at all this.
I know.
Like, this is way too bougie for the ranch.
It's okay. You can be bougie. It's okay.
This is
okay.
Really
bougie. Okay.
Yeah, wait. Talk about Barbie pink, right? Look at the wheels.
All right. Got the dune buggy loaded up and we are headed back to the house. Mom is so excited. She cannot wait. So let's go.
Well, they said they were arriving any minute. Oh my God, here they come. Here they come. Got my new toy on the back end. Oh, look how cute it is. Oh, look how cute. Yay. Here they come. Here it comes. Who's the best grandma in the world? Look at that. Look at that bad boy. Yes. Oh my God. It's so cute. Look how cute. Oh my God. We're going to have some fun. We're going to have some fun. You guys get the gas can from over here by the Well, we can go get more. There it is, there it is, there it is. Now we gotta have these guys help us get it off because we don't have ramps.
Yes.
Look at there. Yeah. Sergio to the rescue. Yes. Look at there.
Mom and her new toy. And let's just say, guys, Mom's probably gonna be the first one to wreck it. Let's just say. Let's just say. Sergio and Zane now. I guess the perks of going and picking up Grandma's toy. He gets to drive it and test it out too. Well, at least we're being cautious, y'all.
They got some fast acceleration.
Okay, Zach just drove. Now it's Zane's turn. Zane has to scoot the chair up a little bit. Little short guy. So look who made it out in the back. He is kicking some booty. Walking, watching the boys hit some golf balls. Look at him over there checking on the chickens. This is like huge, huge progress, you guys. So beyond proud of this man. It's amazing. Thank you. Okay, guys. Look what she's bringing over. Some palm trees. Say hello. Look at the babies. And mom's over here. What are you doing, mom?
Cleaning up chicken poo.
Chicken poo?
It's gonna be the boys' job one of
these days. Yes. Hello?
I don't think so, but.
Hello? Hello? Hello, babies? Are you the one that lets me pet you? Come here, baby. Come here. It is you. Say hello. Hello. Say please pet me. Hello. Say yes. Yeah. I like to get pet. Oh. Yeah. Hi, pretty girl. Say okay. Say thank you. Thank you. Thank you, pretty girl. Thank you.
So, my friends have moved their store. Yay, it's so pretty. Oh my God. So I missed the soft opening last night. So we are coming today. Oh my God, I'm so excited. This is my friend's store, the BLVD. It's the place that we always tell you we're going shopping at. Oh my God, I'm so excited. So excited. It's so pretty. Oh, I cannot wait to get inside and see how pretty it is. Oh my God, how cute is that? The chandelier on the horse's mouth. Oh, cute. Okay, let's go see how it looks. Oh my God, it's so pretty, guys. It is so pretty. I'm so excited. Oh my gosh. So excited. Yes, yes, yes. She's got so much more room. This is so cool, guys. Cannot wait to shop. Yes. Oh my God. Yes. So pretty. If you guys have not come to the new location, you gotta come check it out. They just moved. They're now very close. They're at the corner of Egypt and 2978. So we're so excited. Yay. Come check it out, guys. Come check it out. Let's go shopping. Oh my God. So this is so cool that they created a bar. So there's even more reason for you guys to come shop here, because now you can just sit here with your girlfriend and have a cocktail. Oh my God. How incredibly gorgeous is this. Love it. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. I love it. I love it. I love it. How cute is this? OMG. This is adorable. Oh. I love this. So cute. Oh my God, you guys, you've got to come check out the boulevard. Come shopping and literally sit here with your girlfriends and have a good time. Oh my God, I love how spacious it is. It's so incredibly beautiful. If you have never checked out the boulevard, you've got to come here. It's so pretty. The dressing rooms are gorgeous. Look how pretty. Oh my gosh. Oh, she overdid herself on this place. Amazing. Oh my God. Cute. Four different dressing rooms. All the clothes from her other place still. Oh, you guys. I'm in love. Oh my God. My new store. I mean, I used to love their store at the other location, but now that this is closer and bigger and nicer and everything, it's so bougie. It's so cute. Oh my God. I love it, guys. You gotta come check it out. I'm gonna leave all of their information in the description box below. She actually bought this building, so instead of paying rent, she actually owns this place. A cute, 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 cute place. Gorgeous. Oh my God. You've got to come check it out, guys. Come check it out. It's so cute. Look how cute. Oh my God. Adorable. It's worth the drive no matter where you're at. Even if you're in Houston, you gotta come out. Look how cute. Cute. Okay, I am back at Home Depot. Gotta get some more pavers for the chicken coop and some cinder blocks for my two planters by my front door so I can get those repotted and let you see how pretty that's gonna be. It's gonna be gorgeous. I just love Home Depot. I get so into my head of creation coming to this store. Who would have thought? So let's get home and get this work done today. It's nice. It's actually very hot. It's like 86 degrees out today. So, ooh, these are pretty too. Wow. Okay, let's go check out.
Mm-hmm. This is what we're doing. Yeah, it's that time. Oh my God, look how red my legs are, or my feet. Hot water.
Time to relax, and then I gotta go play golf with the twins. Look at my girls. They're like, oh my goodness, we're so excited. Where's our lunch? Where's our lunch? Oh, there's the lunch. Oh, so healthy for you. Oh, my girls are hungry. Oh my goodness. I never knew raising chickens would bring me so much happiness. Well, get in there. You can't get out. You can't get out. No, you can't get out. Oh, okay, 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 come over here, okay, 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 oh my goodness, yes, 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 oh, so excited.
So guys, I hope you enjoyed today's video, and now just go back to the original part of this video in the beginning and just listen to that again and let it sink in. So for all of you out there that have doubted yourself or have thrown in the towel too early or have just never had the confidence and the determination and the willpower to hang in there, to see it through, you're really missing out on some fantastic things, because throwing in the towel is easy. Giving up is easy. Having self-doubt and just saying, oh, it just wasn't meant for me. I mean, like, all of that is easy. Do you want to take the easy road or do you want to take the hard road? But I'm telling you, if you take the hard road pays off, and sometimes it pays off triple fold. Like, I have accomplished some things in my life that if I would have given up and thrown in the towel, I would have never reaped the benefits of what it felt like winning. Winning in a competition, winning at climbing a mountain, winning at business, winning at friendship, winning at whatever. I mean, if it's worth having, it's worth working for. If it's a marriage, if it's a friendship, look at these past couple years that I've had with my husband and all of his health issues. I could have easily thrown in the towel and said, you know what? I didn't sign up for this crap. I'm out of here. But no, I enjoy my marriage. I enjoy the man I love. I relish my marriage vows. So if you want to have a good marriage, you got to put in the hard work. There's so many people out there nowadays that just think a good relationship or a good marriage is just disposable. Like if it's not working out, you know, I'm done. I'm out of here. No, that's not how things work. Or when business isn't doing so good, you're like, well, you know, it was good for a while, but you know, I might as well hang it up because it's not so good right now. No, you got to ride those bad waves just like you ride the good waves. It's not always meant to be rainbows and sunshine. Sometimes there's some really bad storms, but I guarantee if you ride them out, you will benefit immensely. The benefits are so worth it if you can just ride through the storm and get to the other side where there's rainbows and sunshine. So I hope you enjoyed today's video. I hope you enjoyed today's message. I wish you all a fantastic Monday. It's the fresh new start of everything beautiful. So get out there and live your best life. And until next time, bye-bye.